In this video, I'm going to show you how to start a baking YouTube channel that can bring you as much as $28,000 per month. So make sure you watch this entire video to learn step by step everything that you need to do to start a successful baking YouTube channel. Hello, this is startthechannel.com where we show you step by step how to start a successful YouTube channel and make money. So this is what we are going to cover today. We are going to pick a niche and I'm going to explain to you exactly what that is and why that's so important. We are then going to niche down. Then we are going to get the necessary equipment and talk about your brand colors and why that's so important to launching a successful YouTube channel. After that, we are going to get some channel art. I'll explain exactly what that is and how to do keyword research properly. This is the secret to a successful YouTube channel in the beginning. Next, we are going to create the videos. Then we are going to create some thumbnails and talk about your upload schedule. Finally, we are going to finish up with sharing on social media, five different ways that you can make money, and why you may want to get a website. Now be sure to check out the first link in the description as I have a free YouTube checklist to help you get up and running. So first things first, let's go ahead and take a look at some examples of successful baking YouTube channels. If we take a look at this one right here, the Stay at Home Chef, they have thousands of subscribers and millions of views. As you can see, they are talking about all things baking. They mix in other things, but for the most part, they're dedicated to baking. Here's another example, the Preppy Chef YouTube channel. As you can see, he is getting millions of views with simple baking videos. He shows you exactly step by step how to do it. And his videos really are kind of short, between 5 and 15 minutes long. And you can do this too. So what I recommend that you do, when you first get started, pick a niche. Now, these are large YouTube channels, so they can basically do whatever they want. But in the very beginning, I recommend that you focus either on maybe entire meals or desserts. Focus on one or the other in the very beginning so that you can start building a following. Once you get to 10,000, 20,000, 50,000 subscribers, you can kind of do whatever you want. But focus on desserts. That's going to be a good way to grow, or maybe focus on fast and easy meals or cheap meals, whatever it is, focus on it and you'll be able to grow much faster. And then you want to niche down. And niching down is simply going a little bit deeper and really building a connection with your audience. For example, and this is getting into keyword research a little bit, we're going to talk a little bit more about that in just a moment. But if we just typed in how to bake a chocolate cake, you can see this is a really competitive keyword. There's millions of subscribers, there's millions of views that are being dedicated to just how to make a chocolate cake. However, if you niche down, if we hit the space bar here, you can see how to make a chocolate cake for beginners, how to make a chocolate cake without an oven, how to make a chocolate cake without scratch. If we take a look at this, this is going to be your area of opportunity. I'll talk a little bit more about that in just a moment. But as you can see here, this is what you'd want to do if you wanted to potentially start getting subscribers. This is called niching down. Now, if we jump back over to our slide deck, the next thing that we want to do is we want to get the necessary equipment. If you are going to be recording yourself baking, it is important that you have at least a camera and a microphone to talk through the process. Now, you really don't need much more than that, obviously, in addition to your baking tools. But if you're just getting started, you need three things. You need a camera, a microphone, and some video editing software. Now, I recommend that you check out the second link in the description as it has a complete list of everything that you need. However, if you have no money to invest into your craft, start with your smartphone. Start with your smartphone. It is good enough for audio and video in the beginning. Now, once you start making some money, you definitely want to reinvest, but I recommend that you have, at the very least, you have a decent microphone and a decent camera to record what you're doing. Now, you can actually find video editing software for free. This is a free service right here. It's called openshot.org, and this will work with Mac, Windows, and even Linux. But again, if you don't have a computer and you want to get started, you shouldn't let anything get in your way of getting started. So just start with your smartphone. If you have a Mac, you can actually use QuickTime and you can use iMovie to put everything together and get started. So that is the second link in the description. If you want to know exactly everything that you need, my best recommended products for equipment. Next thing you want to do is you want to determine your brand colors. Now, your brand colors are really important because these are how people are going to identify you. Now, if you take a look, these have really basic brand colors, but you should develop some colors nonetheless, because when people see your channel, they're going to see your colors and they're going to say, yes, I identify. If you look at Preppy Kitchen, it's very simple. Just that black and white here. If you look, his design is very simple. You can pick any color as long as it's congruent with baking. If you have no idea when it comes to brand colors, you can check out something called the Canva color palette. And they've actually put together a lot of colors for you that you can use. And what you do is you find one that you like, you click on this, And it's actually going to give you an example of everything that it looks like and the colors down below. So you can use these colors for your brand. Now, when I'm talking about your brand, I'm talking about your thumbnails, I'm talking about your logo, as well as your channel banner. And speaking of that, the next thing that we want to do is we want to go ahead and get our channel art taken care of. Now, I have a detailed description and write-up of channel art. That's the third link in the description. But what you can do is you can head on over to Canva for free. They have both a free and premium version of Canva. You can start with Canva for free with YouTube channel art. Now, this is the banner that goes on the page. For example, if we look at Preppy Kitchen, this is his banner or channel art, and you can make this for free over on Canva. And it's really easy. You can just click this to get started and then integrate the colors that we found in the previous step. If you have no eye for design, you can hire someone to do it for as little as $5. If we scroll up here and we type in YouTube channel art, as you can see, there are people that are willing to put together very high quality channel art for as little as $5 or $10. You just give them the colors that you found in the previous step, tell them that your channel is about baking, and share your vision. If you have images that you want on your channel art, they'll actually take care of that for you, but you can hire someone to do it for as little as $5. Now, if we jump back over to our slide deck, the next thing that we want to take a look at is keyword research. Now, I alluded to keyword research just a couple minutes ago when it comes to your YouTube channel. Keyword research is going to be really important when you get started, simply because you aren't going to have a dedicated group of followers that are going to just watch every video. And so you want to go ahead and build that. And the best way to build it is with keyword research. And there are two ways to do keyword research. There's a difficult way that I showed you, how to build a chocolate cake and then hitting spacebar and going through and seeing all of the different options. A better way to do it is to download a Chrome extension. And that's actually the fourth link in the description. Right here, as you can see, download a Chrome extension. And what you'll do is go over to Keyword Explorer, and then you can just type in how to bake a chocolate cake. And the great thing about this extension is it's going to give you the difficulty, so how hard it would be for your YouTube channel to rank. So this says it's a 71, so that's very good. And it actually gives you a few options. Now, there is a free and paid version of this, but you can get started for free. So if we did how to bake a chocolate cake without eggs, maybe there our keyword difficulty will actually go up. So before it was 71, this one's actually an 88. So if you know how to make a chocolate cake without eggs, this is going to be a great opportunity. So I recommend that you go ahead and click the fourth link in the description and get this keyword tool, because it's going to help you grow faster. Again, in the very beginning, you don't have a following. And so you want to make sure that you are creating content that people are actually looking for. And the best way to do that is with keyword research and to just type in a keyword. So we're going to close that. And then if we jump back over here, the next step is to create videos. The purpose of YouTube is either to entertain people or to educate. And if we take a look at these channels here, you're going to see they're doing just that. They're being educational. They're showing you step by step how to get stuff done. Now, what you can do is obviously you can point your camera at your cooking table or your island, wherever you're cooking. And what you may want to do to make sure that people are engaged and focused is to change the camera angle every 7 to 15 seconds. So if you've noticed, I will move my mouse or I'll switch over every 7 to 15 seconds just to make sure that you are still engaged and you're still paying attention. One thing that you can do too is you can actually go get B-roll. Now, B-roll is basically footage that will overlay on top of the regular footage, and you can get that for free, for example, with a website like Pexels, or you can use something called Storyblocks, which is a premium service. So you could get started with Pexels by typing in, let's say, baking. And when we type in baking, there's going to be over 2,000 images of baking. And you could use this as text overlay, you could use this as B-roll overlay in your videos. As you can see, there's a lot of options. And you can do the same thing with this premium service. And the benefits of using a premium service is they have 4K, and they also have a video editor right on their site, so you don't have to spend any additional money on video editing if you don't want to. So if you take a look at this, as you can see, they have tons of different options when it comes to B-roll, and I recommend that you change the camera angle, you change the viewing angle every 7 to 15 seconds. It also works if you have a weird sound, a sound that people aren't expecting, that will bring people back to your channel and help you watch a little bit longer. So if we go back over to our slide deck, the next step is to create thumbnails. Now, when it comes to creating thumbnails, you can create them for free using Canva. Once again, you can just type in YouTube thumbnail. If we type in thumbnail here, hit enter, you can see there are free and paid options. As you can see, top 10 cake recipes. This is a paid one, but there are free ones as well. Once again, if you don't want to create your own or you don't know how to create your own, you can also go over to Fiverr and you can type in YouTube thumbnail, as you will see here, thumbnail just like this, and you can hire someone to do your thumbnails for as little as $5. And this one actually says within 2 hours, so they can get it done quick. Now, what I recommend that you do to get started, if you're going to do your thumbnails yourself, you want to model what's already working. So if we go up to how to bake a chocolate cake and hit enter, you want to make sure that your thumbnails are modeled after what's already working. So take a look at the top 10 and you want to make sure that your thumbnails look something like that, because we know that it already works. And because you have no subscribers, no followers, you want to make sure that you are doing what everyone else is doing. Model it. Don't steal, obviously, or copy. Model it so that it looks similar to what's already out there. As you can see, most of these have a piece of cake. This person's looking at the cake. So I would do something like this just to show the finished product. So this is a really good idea. And you could actually make this really easy over on Fiverr. You simply would click create blank YouTube thumbnail and then take a picture of the finished product. And then you can just put that right in on your screen and put it right in on your thumbnail and away you go. So it's actually really easy, but make sure that you are modeling what is already working. If we jump back over to our slide deck here, the next thing is that you want to upload on a schedule. If you want success on YouTube, you need to upload on a schedule in the very beginning. I recommend that you upload 3 times per week. Now, 3 times per week may seem like it's a lot, but really it isn't. That's the minimum requirement to get up and running. Now, if you, once you get established and you have 5,000 subscribers, you can kind of pull back on that and change your upload schedule. But it's no secret that the more you upload on YouTube, the more opportunities you have for success. The more opportunities you have for success, the better your chances are you're going to connect with your audience. But if we look at this, you can see he's uploading at least a couple times per week. He just uploaded yesterday, in fact, and then 2 days before that, he's uploading about 2 times per week, and he has over 2 million followers. Now, he probably has more time. What I recommend that you do is I recommend that you batch out your content. And basically what that means is on a Saturday or whatever day you have, create 3 or 5 videos for the entire week. So that way you're not trying to bake every single day. So dedicate a Saturday. If you can only do 2 videos on a Saturday, that's fine, but make sure that you batch out your content and that'll actually help you stay on schedule. But getting on schedule and staying there is very important. The next thing that you want to do is share your content on social media. Now, there is a right way and a wrong way to share your content on social media. What most people will do is they'll jump over to Facebook and they'll share their YouTube videos to their personal wall. That is the absolutely wrong way to go about it. What you should do instead is find relevant Facebook groups. Maybe we'll type in baking and hit enter. And the reason why you shouldn't share your content on your personal page is most of your friends and family aren't going to care about your YouTube channel until you start getting millions of subscribers and views. And then they'll say they were there from the very beginning. But what you'll want to do is go down to groups. And then if you take a look, you can see baking tips and tricks, 246,000 members, 41,000 members under baking and cooking for beginner. What you can do is you can join these groups for free. You could even create your own group if you wanted to, but you can join these groups for free. Be helpful first. So answer questions, solve problems. And then when it comes time for you to upload or share your video, there won't be a big issue with it. But it's important that you want to make sure that you are part of the community first. You don't want to just spam your YouTube video links. No one's going to appreciate that. But make sure you also read the rules of the road and make sure that it is okay. But you can see there are thousands of opportunities to get views on these different groups. So if we go back over here, we've talked about sharing on social media. Of course, you can share on Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, LinkedIn, anywhere and everywhere. But you may want to make sure that you're doing it the right way. The next thing we want to take a look at is 5 ways to make money. There are many ways to make money, and we're going to cover 5. I do have the 5th link in the description that goes over more ways to make money, but let's go ahead and talk about a few of those right now. The most obvious way and common way to make money is with the YouTube Partner Program. And with this YouTube Partner Program, you need 4,000 watch hours and 1,000 subscribers in order to qualify. Just because you qualify doesn't mean that you'll be accepted, but those are the minimum requirements. And in my opinion, this is the least profitable way to make money on YouTube. There are so many other ways. One good way to make money is simply with affiliate marketing. Now, with affiliate marketing, you are recommending or selling other people's products and services. And the way that affiliate marketing works is that if you recommend, let's say, a stand mixer, and someone buys that stand mixer using your affiliate link, you get paid a commission. Now, the reason why I bring up stand mixer is because that's such a great opportunity for the baking niche. You can recommend all of the products that you use, everything from the knives all the way down to the stand mixer or the Instapot recipe or whatever it may be, and you can earn a commission. This is a good way to make money because it's working for you 24 hours a day. So that's just one way. Another way that you can make money is with email marketing. That's simply collecting emails, email addresses, and then sending out emails whenever you upload a brand new video or there's a new product that you're recommending. Email marketing is a great way to make money 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Another way that you can make money is by selling your own digital and physical products. Maybe you have a cookbook that you put together and you sell that baking book for as little as $5. If we take his most recent video, which has 32,000 views, if we just take this to 32,000, and let's assume that just 1% buy this book, 1%, so that's 320 people. 320, multiply that by 5 because you're selling the book for $5, and you're looking at an additional $1,600 just from one video. Now, just imagine this is within 19 hours. So you'd make $1,600 in 19 hours. Just imagine if you put that on all of your videos and this guy is getting millions of views, you can see how that could add up. But creating your own physical and digital products is a very good opportunity to make some money. Another way you can make money, and this is pretty common, is by starting something like a Patreon or even a private Facebook group where you charge every single month. That's a good opportunity because you can be more intimate. You can share more tips and tricks. You can actually go live and talk to people one-on-one. That's another opportunity as well. And the final thing that we want to cover today is to get a website. Now, this is optional, but I recommend that you get a website right away. The reason why I think you should get a website is, what happens if YouTube disappears tomorrow, or the stay-at-home chef, maybe their channel gets deleted or hacked? What happens? They would have to start over. But if they had a website, they wouldn't be starting over from scratch. They would be starting over from step 2 or 3, and then they can rebuild from there. But I recommend that you get a website just so that, again, you can, it's another income stream. It's another way to connect with your audience and build a following and make even more money. So be sure to check out the links in the description. The first link is for that checklist. That checklist is 100% free. The second link in the description is for the necessary equipment. I have a list of the best equipment based on my research. After that, I have a guide on channel art. And then next we talk about keyword research. Again, that's that free Chrome plugin that you would want to get so that you can go faster. And then we talk about different ways to make money and then why you should get a website. So be sure to like, subscribe, ring the bell if this video or any other video on the channel helped you out. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you tomorrow.